Soil classification, soil formation, parent rock, which is divided into residual and transportation soil, in situ weathering by physical chemical agents of parent rock is residual soils. Transported soils, weathered and transported by wind or water and ice and far away from the parent rock is called transported soils. Parent rock formed by one of these three different processes: igneous, sedimentary and metamorphic. Formed by cooling of molten magma is igneous, that is granite. Formed by gradual deposition and in layers, that is limestone shale. Metamorphic, formed by alteration of igneous sedimentary rocks by pressure, temperature, that is, example is marble. Residual salts, formed by in situ weathering parent rock. Soil classification. To classify the soil into a group according to the soil behavior and physical shape. Type of classification. Classification by visual, ASTO or UCS. Soil test, Atterberg limits, sieve analysis and hydrometer analysis. Major soil groups. Two types of groups are there. One is cohesive soils and another one is granular soils or cohesionless soils. 0.002 mm or less are called clays, and above that are silts, and 0.075 mm and above are sands. 2.36 mm above are gravel, and 63 mm above are cobble, and 200 mm is boulder. The grain sizes are different. 75 micron or less are called as fine grain soils, and above are called as coarse grain soils. The graph drawn between particle size and percentage finer is called as a grading curve. These grading curves are different types. One, red one. If red one is there and it is distributed from some place to some place, that is well graded, means all types of particles are present. If it is uniformly graded, that is only one type of particle is dominant and present in the soil. And poorly graded or there is one gap graded, that is some particle sizes are missing. So all these things, well graded with some clay, means the particles are which are less than 0.002 is present. So well graded with, that is in a green curve it is shown. The grading curve is used for to determine the D10, D30 and D60. The D60 means 60% finer of that particle size there, and D30 is the diameter of the particle is 30% finer, and D10 is 10% finer and the particle size at D10. So, to calculate CU, coefficient of uniformity or coefficient of curvature, CU is equal to D60 by D10 and CC is equal to D30 square by D60 into D10. These things are used in filter design. Well graded or poorly graded soils. Well graded soils, wide range of grain sizes are present and coefficient of curvature is equal to 1 to 3 and CU is greater than 4. And sands, CC is 1 to 3 and CU is greater than 6. And other including two special cases, poorly graded soils, uniform soils, grain size of same size, gap graded soils, no grains in specific size range as it said above. Atterberg limits are index properties which gives the relationship between grain size and the water present. Borderline water contents separating the different states of fine grains are given below. Zero and shrinkage limit, plastic limit, liquid limit, they are all defined, and that is of the water content. These are all only water contents. And above liquid limit, the soil behaves as liquid, and plastic limit and liquid limit, the soil is a plastic, and the plastic limit and shrinkage limit, the soil behaves as semi-solids and brittle solid below shrinkage limit. Shrinkage limit. First, and porcelain dish and the soil mass with completely saturated and soil volume is measured, and then it is dried and the soil volume is a soil mass into, and so shrinkage limit is equal to the water content at that and the water content in this, and minus will give you this one, m1 minus m2 by m2 into 100 minus v1 minus v final by m2 into gamma w into 100. This means the volume of final one is measured by replacing the shrinkage limit definition. The water content at which the soil volume ceases to change is defined as the shrinkage limit. Means the water content, moisture content and water content versus volume of soil is there, and the volume reduces. When the water reduces, volume reduces, and the volume comes to from liquid limit, it reaches liquid limit and then to plastic limit, then to shrinkage limit. After that, the reduction in moisture content will not there will no reduction in volume. With the consistency limits purely based on liquid limit and plasticity index, the plasticity index versus liquid limit or moisture content will give you a classifying the soils, clays or silts. There is a line, below that are silts and above that are clays. And 50% liquid limit, if it crosses 50 limits, then it is all above the A line or highly plastic clays, and below A line is highly plastic silts. 35 to 50, it is intermediate plasticity of clays, and below 35% low plasticity is there. Indices: plasticity index, liquidity index, there are so many indices are there for describing the range of water content of which soil was plastic. Plasticity index is liquid limit minus plastic limit. Liquidity index is for scaling the natural water content of soil sample to the limits. That is, if the natural water content of the soil minus plastic limit divided by plasticity index is called as, that water content is called as liquidity index. If liquidity index is less than 0, brittle or fracture or sheared soil. Liquidity index is just less than 1, fraction, like the plastic soil, if shear is greater than 1, viscous liquid is shear. Sensitivity of the soil for clays: strength undisturbed and strength disturbed. Unconfined strength of the soil is the called sensitivity index. If low sensitive and range of low sensitive, high sensitive, or some typical values of sensitivity are given. Indices: activity A, that is Kempton 1953. A is equal to plasticity index by percentage of clay fraction, that is by weight. Clay fraction is less than 0.002 mm. Purpose is both type and amount of clay in soils will affect the Ekterberg's limits. This index is aimed to separate them. Normal clays 0.75 A and less than 1.2, and in between that is a normal clays. Inactive clays A is less than 0.75, active clays A is greater than 1.25. That's how it is determined.